Ik denk dat dit een van de laatste keren is dat ik in deze lift sta. Zo'n geweldig punt dat je zo in die straat, 40th Street, en dan kijk je daar naar East River en daar naar de Hudson River. Ja, vind ik altijd fabelachtig.
I'm going to give you a tour of the Gustavus Niagus Foundation Library, formerly known as the Mid-Manhattan Library, or MML, in New York. It's part of the campus plan we created for two libraries, the Stephen E. Schwarzman Building. It's the research library with the famous Rose Main Reading Room. And the Mid-Manhattan Library, New York's largest and busiest lending library. This building was built as a department store in 1915. The remarkable thing is that the building is from the same period as the Schwarzman Building, the Beaux-Arts period. And there's only 3 years in between these two buildings. In 1917, the department store became a library. I'll take you inside. We took pictures of the library before the renovation. When I first came to this library, I thought, oh, there is no light, there is no openness, it smells, it feels worn out. There are very old, high bookcases. You can't find anything. Books are in front of the windows. But at the same time, it's packed with people. So you could see how badly this library was needed. People are very close to each other, very close together. They are disconnected from daylight. It's not exactly hygienic. There's poor ventilation and walking routes, and how you borrow and return your books are very illogical. This is the place where you could collect the books you had reserved. The elevators often didn't work. The stairwell was very decentralized and unpleasant. Nobody could see or find it. There wasn't really a place for children and not enough space for teenagers. This is a teenagers' corner they had made, but we wanted to give them much, much more space. The offices and conference rooms were at the very top of the building, with very low rooms, very low ceilings. Here I'm standing on the roof of the Schwarzman Building and I'm looking to the Stavros Niarchos Foundation Library. And you can see there are many, many service installations on the roof. When we walked through that installation room, we did experience a roof with an amazing view to Fifth Avenue. In the US, I always see that there are only installations on roofs. And I thought, can't we use this roof for public programming and a public garden? We bring more light into the building with a logical wayfinding for the visitors. We are turning the building into a real library by creating a long room and organizing book storage there. This library has a lot of books, and if you put them everywhere, this means there would be bookcases all over and not enough space to sit, to study, or to read. What's the concept? Something very ingenious. We made a cut in the three existing floors and made a void. On the right-hand side, we created 5 floors with high bookcases. And on the left-hand side, we kept the 3 floors. Here you can see what the space looks like. In the long room, we can store a lot of books in a very compact way. And now the floors can be used much more to create seating areas. We are now on the roof, where we created, in what I call the wizard hat, a conference center with a publicly accessible roof terrace from where you can oversee Fifth Avenue, the Schwarzman Building, and Bryant Park. Construction has taken the past 2-3 years, and I've been to New York quite a lot during that time. The daily management of the project was with our local partner, Beyer Blinder Bell, BBB.
Ja, het is super om hier nu te zijn, want eigenlijk is nu alles weggesloopt. Dus nu zie je eigenlijk de grote lijnen van het gebouw. Dat trappenhuis moet nog weg. Maar je kan nu ook goed zien waar hier nu, hoe wij hier ramen in die muur gaan maken. Dit kon je vroeger helemaal niet zien. Dus je moet je ook voorstellen, die werken hier mensen al 30 jaar. En die wisten helemaal niet dat er eigenlijk achter die muur dat kleine parkje zat. Dat je daar ramen in kon maken. Die zagen alleen altijd maar dat ze in een gebouw zaten zonder ramen.
Kijk, dit zijn onze tekeningen, onze documenten. Die zie je, Meccano, Thea Blindertel en al onze consultants. Dat is niet altijd op de bouw, dus alles wat ze moeten doen, dit is mechanical. Dus we hebben echt je tekent voor zo'n project echt duizenden tekeningen.
Nou, je ziet eigenlijk ook van hoe dat slopen, dat je dat eigenlijk heel precies moet doen. En je komt eigenlijk ook altijd weer verrassingen tegen. Hè? Dat zijn dus ook bijvoorbeeld deze wand, die was slechter dan ze hadden gedacht. Dus daar hebben ze nu eigenlijk al helemaal deze soort hulpwand moeten plaatsen. Maar het is ook altijd weer spannend, ja, wat zit er achter al die plafondplaten? Hè? Klopt die constructie nog? Hier zit een zwaardere constructie dan daar. Nou ja, het zijn altijd verrassingen. Dit is het fascinerende van Manhattan. Dus alles wat gesloopt wordt hier uit het gebouw, moet in hele kleine pakketjes, in deze containers. En dan wordt het zo afgevoerd naar de straat, naar de stoep. En er staan weer kleine lorries, kleine vrachtwagens die het afvuren.
Pouring cement or concrete are organized with small containers. This has to do with the whole logistical challenge of Mid-Manhattan, New York.
It's there.
Cool, hè? Oh.
Dit is echt het volume. Dit is de Wizard Hat.
Ja.
Het is nu mid-september. Nu staat de hele staalconstructie er. En het grappige is, we hebben zo hard gewerkt, want die staalconstructie moest vooruit lopen en het moest allemaal uitgetekend worden. En nu staat het er allemaal. Dus dat is op het dak, maar ook alle vierdes en de long room, er is ook alle staal aangebracht. Dus in de zomer is er eigenlijk ongelooflijk veel gebeurd. Dus dit is echt een geweldig moment om er nu te zijn.
The remarkable thing is that the wizard hat was actually the simplest part of the building to make. Because it's no new construction. The steel construction is very well made, precisely detailed, and really made in New York through men who sit on the construction beams. I love it. Here I look back from the roof of the Schwarzman building to the Wizard Hat under construction. Here you can see the intervention for what I call the long room. It may seem simple on drawing, but in reality it is quite complicated. An entire steel construction had to be built to make 5 floors out of 3 floors. It's very good that we did it. We are now in 2019. You can see that the construction of the roof is almost complete. Also, you can see the reference to the roofs in the area around us from the Beaux-Arts period, from which our wizard hat took the inspiration.
Kijk, dit is de plantenbak. Dus dit wordt helemaal gevuld met planten en kleine boompjes. Zo leuk toen we dit aan het maken waren. Dan zag het er net uit alsof we een zwembad aan het maken waren. Dus iedereen dacht, oh, er komt een zwembad op de bibliotheek. Maar heel erg belangrijk vonden wij en ook de opdrachtgever dat er ook groen en beplanting toegevoegd zou worden. En hier zitten we tegen de buren en dan konden we het dak niet verhogen. Dus dat hebben we dan met dit deel gemaakt, wat ik dan die geheime tuin noem. Met dit deel hebben we allemaal verhoogd om meer naar de stad terug te kunnen kijken.
Ik denk dat onze grootste issue is de zon. During construction, we were still busy choosing materials and selecting the best colors for the floor covering for the children's section on the lower ground floor.
Right. No, it's
We often meet with the New York Public Library team and with Bea Blender-Bell, BBB, our local partner. Also with artist Hayal Posanti, who designed the ceiling painting. and we designed a chair, the new public library chair, together with Thomas Moser. These are the images from the last time I was there before I couldn't get there again because of COVID. Here you can see all the colors that are applied. These are the windows created in a former blind wall facing a pocket park. The walls around the elevators cladded with travertin. The bookcases are bronze colored. There's a lot of perimeter seating on all floors. You can sit all the way along the facade at very nice tables that are very easy to keep clean and very strong. We used solid and timeless materials. We did introduce not only a long room, but also long tables. You can see it very nicely now here from above, because they are still under construction. This is a children area in the lower ground floor, and we made a void so that the children get daylight. Here we are in the wizard hut. At this moment they are finishing the ceiling, and I'm checking the final floor covering with Martijn, whether it looks really good or not.
En we hebben dus nu net de vloerbedekking van beneden, hebben het stuk meegenomen naar boven. Dat hier neergelegd, want dan kan je eigenlijk goed zien hoe het met het hout en het brons werkt. En eigenlijk was altijd het idee dat het matcht met de kleur van natural stone. En dat matcht die ook wel.
I hope you all come to the Stavros Niarchos Foundation Library and that you will enjoy the Wizard Hat for all New Yorkers. This is what it used to be. And so it's now the Stavros Niarchos Foundation Library with a Dutch touch in New York.